think you are passionate about so many things, but mostly you're known in Africa as a singer, as a songwriter, as an artist, a performer. What is the role of an artist, and how do you use your voice to bring about change for children?
Well, I learned from the traditional musician in my country that when you are gifted with the talent of storytelling or singing, it's up to you to educate your peers, to speak about what is going on a daily basis, to know where you come from, to know your own history through other storytellers or singers, and you pass on. You just don't keep it. It's educating people, and also you learn on the process of educating people. Because as people tell the stories, and you relate to that story, you add your story to it.
22% of primary school children have either left school, dropped out, or never been to school in Africa. That's a staggering number. How does that make you feel? It must be very frustrating.
It is frustrating because it's not the commitment of the community or the parents that is lacking. It's the commitment of the leaders. It's a matter of leadership. Because you have to realize that education is a very political subject. When people are educated, you cannot have free dictator walking around saying nonsense, because we can cut them off on the lie and hold them accountable to what they say. So how do we hold the leaders accountable? If we continue doing politics the way we do politics, and with African leaders, nothing's gonna change, because there will always be somebody from a rich country that have an interest in the country that is willing to pay them billions of dollars to get what they need and doesn't invest in their people. Morality in business have to come to play. If we don't change the way we corrupt the leaders in Africa and put incentives on it, saying, okay, we're gonna do this. We're gonna come bring jobs here, or we're gonna come, we need this in your country. But we will give you money. Every place have corruption. It exists in America, it exists in Europe, but it doesn't impact the development of the country, because there is a GDP that is there, people work, and there's a system in place. The rule of law is evident in America and in Europe, but the rule of law is not evident in Africa, even though in our constitution, in our laws, everything we're talking about is there. There is a law against rape, sexual harassment, but it's not implemented.
So how do you do that?
How do you do that? Hey, we use internet. We have to be savvy about this. We have to change our way of doing things. We always trying to preserve what we have and not to put it at danger to make a change. To make a change, you have to give something away. We cannot change this world thinking that we're gonna put a little bit of Band-Aid on a hole like that and hope and think that the Band-Aid gonna last forever. It will take effort from each one of us to be willing to give something away for that change to happen. And if we do that, we have to make it crystal clear. I don't understand in this internet era why we don't oust enough the leaders about what they do. So in this global world, what is the problem in this global world? There's not enough accountability, trustability, and respect of life. The only thing we all bend on our knees for is money, and that money is gonna kill us. Profit is the nuclear weapon that's gonna explode everything. Because we make ourselves believe that if we achieve wealth, then we have succeeded. How can you achieve wealth when you know that you achieve that wealth at the cost of millions of lives?
Do you think that the entire way of educating children today needs to change? And if so, why, how?
We need to give them education that are based on their reality, really. And we need to train our teachers differently in Africa. The curriculum has to change. We Africans have to write our history book. Enough of those nonsense that we hear about ourselves. Our history has been told by the slaver and the colonizer. Where are the historian, African historian? Where are the African academics? They got to come together and come up with something that gives to our children the pride they need to be able to live in this global village. Other countries does that. We don't do it in different countries in Africa. And that is the problem that we're having with education. We also need to make our leaders accountable to that. And we have to teach our girls reproductive science. Tell them, especially when they reach puberty, to tell them what is going to happen. We have to tell them it's okay to say no to an elderly man that wants to give you money to have sex with it. That have to be part of curriculum. Every different scenario out there that the men use for the girl to drop out of school have to be taught. We cannot waste life too much, because every time we make mistake and we don't correct it, not only that we lose one life, we lose 10 lives.
And your message then to young people in Africa, the leaders of tomorrow rather than the leaders of today, who you clearly don't have much faith in the leaders of today, what is your message to them?
For them to be organized, to be prepared to take lead in their country and not to become what they are removing. They have to be democratic. They have to understand that democracy doesn't mean you have to stay in power forever. That they have to come with a plan. What are the agenda they're going to have? Economically, in education, in health, in building infrastructures, because we need infrastructures in Africa. We need roads, we need rail, we need waterways, we need airports to function for people to be able to travel from one country to the other, for goods to travel within Africa. So new leaders in Africa, they have to be savvy. They really have to be the next democratic generation. You can be elected twice, not more. After the two term, you step out, you step down. It gotta be in the plan before you go out there to oust somebody. Otherwise, what happened with the Arab Spring gonna be worse with us, because it's gonna be a chaos.
Of all the words that you've written and the words that you've sung, what would be encapsulated your message to youth in your music?
What I always sing about, especially for the youth of my country, and for my continent, is you gotta move on up. You gotta get out of your chair. You're too comfortable in the laziness, it doesn't work. You wanna change, go grab it, work for it. And in doing so, you gotta respect yourself and respect everybody else. Opinion and everybody else's integrity. If you don't have those, you're not a leader for me. So my message to the youth is always that. Don't shut down your soul. Don't shut down your head. Keep love and respect always in your focus. You can do so much when you're that type of person.